Okay, the first sentence. Okay, so if I want to generate a set or a list of character that I will be used, they will be used for to label the graph vertices. So I use okay. Actually, if you want to write the list of A to M, right? If you are lazy, right, you can just simply like the character length A to M like this, so you get the result that is a list of the character from A to M. And then this, I will save or assign this list to the vertex V, the vertex list V. Okay, and then if I want to create the edge, right, by connecting A to B, B to C, C to D, right, I have to write like this, right? But this one is the undirected edge, right? Undirected edge. So normally if you want to write A to B, right, you can just simply use minus and greater than sign, and then it will automatically generate to the arrow. But if you want to write the undirected edge, you have to use escape UE and then escape. Can you follow me? You can write escape. You can press escape, okay, and UE undirected edge, and then press escape. Don't type like this, okay? You have to press escape and then UE and then escape, and then it will generate the what we call the undirected edge like this. Okay. For example, I want to write X UE and then escape. Okay, it will generate directed edge from the node X to Y, something like this. Okay, this is an undirected edge. Undirected edge, DG. Okay. And then I will get this and then shift enter. You can see the edge, right? That has been generated like this. And then this is the way to create the graph, right? With the set of vertices and the edges. And then the next thing is that if you want to combine them into a graph, right, you can just simply use the function graph V and H, and then you will assign to G, right? Okay, now the graph has been generated like this, right, automatically. Okay, so you don't have to draw it. If you write the program in C, maybe you have to know how to connect to the graphic mode on the screen, and then you have to use the graphic mode in order to show the graph like this. But for Mathematica, you don't have to do that. You can just simply use the function. You have to know the function graph, right? And then it can be generated automatically. From this graph, you can see that these are the nodes will be connected according to the edge that we have already defined in the edge list like this, right? And you can see this isolated node here, this is a node K, right? It's not connect to any node. Okay. And then if you want to change the style, this style is not clear to you, right? Maybe you have to define the vertex label and the style, right? In this way, you can use graph V and H, right? And then you can set the vertex label, right? Name and center, the vertex style to be black, and the vertex size, the size of the node is too small. Maybe you can change to 0.5, and the vertex label style, you can use the directive way, right, to be the vertex label sound that is a A, B, C, D, U, we have to show it in terms of the white character and italic way, right? So now you can see the vertex like this, right? The black vertex sound, right? And then the character will be displayed in white italic, okay? So it's very simple, right? You may have to know the setup or the attributes of the function graph, right? So you can show the graphic neatly, okay? And for the S style, if you want to, okay, to make it better for visualization, right? Okay, this way you change the color of the edge into red, right? The edge style is red and thicker one. Okay, so you can see the graph like this. And then if you think this one is quite, it's not perfect for you, maybe you want to show the edge in terms of the good coordinates location, so you may have to set the coordinate, right? Like for example, for the first node A, right, you want to put at the location 3, 4 and the node B 4, 4, right? You can just simply use the vertex coordinates like this. You can also put like this. Why it is 3, 3, 4? 3, 4 mean in X direction is 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, right? It's the coordinate of A is 3, 4. Coordinate of B is 4, 4. For C is 1, 3. 1, 3. Okay. Okay, like this. Is this graph familiar with you? If you could remember in the morning class, like Dr. Sansari has already shown you this graph already. Okay, this is graph for for the graph that we are going to write the program, you know, to write the depth first search. Okay. And the result that has been explained that in the morning, that is a result from this program. Okay, by using the depth first search function like this. Do you remember depth first search function or depth first search algorithms? Okay, I will remind you again. Okay, for the depth first search, like first of all, you have to start from the first vertex, right? You have to define the first vertex that we are going to go for the depth first search algorithm. Okay, first of all, you have to push the first vertex to the stack. Okay, in this program, you will push G, right? G node. Oh, I'm not sure which one. Oh, push the first node. What is the first node? What does it mean by depth first search? Oh, push G first. Okay. Okay, for the depth first search algorithm, first of all, you have to push the first vertex right onto the stack and then mark this vertex as visited. So in the Mathematica program, like if you want to mark it as a visited, so first of all, you have to move this vertex to another list, to the visited list, and delete the vertex from the vertex list, okay? And then you have to repeat, right? Visit the next vertex. What is the next vertex? It will be the vertex that is adjacent to the top, the stack, that is G, right? In this figure, what are the vertices that connected to, or it is adjacent to the node G? Please answer. You can type or you can turn on your microphone and then answer to me. I know that it is after the lunch time. You feel asleep, right? Please help me teaching. what are the notes? Adjacent note or the note that is like to the one that is on the top of stack. Suppose the top of stack or the stack. The note in the stack is G. How many vertices that is connected to G? H and C, right? C and H, right? Okay, so you have to push this vertex. You have to select either C or H first, and then push this vertex to the stack, and then mark this as vertex visited. Mark this vertex as visited. And you have to do, right? If there is no vertex to visit, you can pop off the stack and then mark as. And you have to do this loop, right, until the stack is empty. Okay, so you have, that means that you have already visited every node in this graph. Okay, this is very simple, right? The first search. Okay, so I will do step by step, right? First of all, I will start from the initialization. Okay, the result will be the MST, right? So the first search, is the minimum spanning tree, right? The result of the first search spanning tree is the minimum spanning tree for by using this first search algorithm. Okay, MST. So first vertex list G, right? From the previous line of the previous instruction, right? We want to show the vertex list of the graph G, right? And by using vertex list, and we put into the vertex variable. Okay, chief enter. So you can see that from the graph, right? We all can transform or we can use function vertex list in order to show the list of the vertex name. And then you assign this vertex to unvisited, right? We initialize to unvisited list of vertex to the vertex. And then in order to use, we have to use stack, right? In C programming, maybe you have to write a program in order to solve push, pop, peak, right, for the stack. But for Mathematica, you can just simply use create data structure stack, and then you can assign to stack. So now stack is a stack data structure. And then you have to set up initialize MST minimum spanning tree into the empty set. Okay, so here we have the vertex and unvisited vertex, and then the data structure like this. Okay, and then first of all, you have to check for the stack, right? Whether it is empty or not. Okay, you can use stack empty queue. Empty queue, queue means question, to ask whether the stack is empty or not, right? Okay, here it is initialized. The stack is just initialized to be the first time to be used. So the stack is empty. This is true. And then we have to show data in the stack by using the stack visualization. Because there is nothing in the stack, right? So it's empty. And this one is a pointer to the top of the stack, but there is nothing in the stack. So it will show like this. Easy. So in order to make it clear for you, maybe I will push one to the stack. Okay, when I push one to stack and show it, right? It will show one here, and the top of stack will point to one as well. Am I speaking too fast? Do you still following me? Okay, here, now we are the top of stack, we point to the element one, right? And if I want to, do you remember the operation peak? What does it mean by peak? who answer my question, I will give you an extra point. Thank you. Who is that? See the value without pop. Ah, thank you, Natcha. That's right. Oh, you have to answer to everyone. Look at the topmost element in stack. See the value. Okay, uh-huh. Okay, thank you, Natcha and you. That's right. Okay, so when I use this one, pick, so, okay, the value one will be disappeared, will be displayed. And then, okay, you use pop. Okay, one will be pop out of the stack, and then the stack will be empty again. Okay, this is the stack operation, push, pop, and pick. Okay, come back to the depth first search algorithm. First of all, I would like to start from the node G, right? That's why I push G and then see what's happened. Okay, G has been pushed into this stack. And then, okay, the third step, mark this vertex as was visited. Okay, to mark the vertex of this visited, so we have to delete G from the unvisited. Okay, unvisited. So you have to use delete cases, unvisited G. Okay, now you can see that from in the list, G has been disappeared. Okay, has been deleted. Okay, and then we have to go inside the loops, right? To check for the stack is empty or not, right? We have to do this while loop, right? Until the stack is empty. But now the stack is not empty, right? Because you have just pushed G into onto the stack. And then the next one, you have to visit the next vertex adjacent to the one on the top of the stack. What is the one on the top of the stack? G, right? G. So you have to check for, yeah, using the peak, right? G is the top of the stack, right? It's peak. So you get the value of the top of the stack, right, into you without popping. And then what you have to do next, so you have to find the ADJ adjacent matrix, or it is the adjacency vertices of you. If you have to find the nodes that is connected from G, right? From G, it will be placed into the adjacency matrix adjacent vertices of U. What is U? U is G, right? These adjacent vertices must not be element of unvisited set. Okay. So first of all, you have to get the adjacency list, right, from this graph, right, that is connect from you, right? And then you have to use the intersection of the set, right? The adjacency matrices here, we have to be not to be in the intersection with the unvisited. Do you understand my point? If the vertex is visited, so it will not be included in this adjacency list, or we will not concern about this vertex anymore. Okay, so that's why we have to use intersection in order to find the connected, the adjacent vertices with the G, with the node G, right? And then that node has to be in the set of unvisited list. Okay, so when I type, so now the result is C and H, because C and H is connected to G. C and H are connected to G node. Okay, so C and H, and C and H has not yet been visited. ยังไม่ได้ถูกเยี่ยมเนาะโอเคUp to now, do you have any questions? And then the next vertex adjacent to U is vertex C, right? The next thing that you have to do is you have to check for the first vertex, right? In Mathematica, if you want toOkay, so okay, vertex this is V, right? Okay, if you want to get the first element of this array, the list in the Mathematica can be treated as an array of something, okay, array of objects. And then if you want to access to the first element in this array or this list, so you can just simply use double bracket, and then instead of using zero, you can use one. Mathematica is very easy to use, right? In terms of the human being, right? You have to start from the index 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Not 0, 1, 2, 3. So if you want to get the first element of this array, right? You can just use V1. Okay, you can get A. Okay. Yes, you can get A. If V2, you can get B. Okay. So you have to check for the first vertex.Right, the first vertex in the list. So you push this first adjacent vertex right into the list. So you have to use stack push. Right. So now the top of stack will be C. Why do we have to push C into the stack? Because after G, right, we have to check.Elements that is connected to G one by one, right? In this case, we have C and H branches, right? Branches. So you have to go for C branch first, and then so on, and then go on. Okay. So that's why we have to push into the stack G and then C. Right. So what is the next thing that we have to do is you have to repeat this process, right? To check for the adjacent vertices of C, but you have to mark this one, mark C as visited, right? Because we have already go for G, for C now, so we have to delete adjacent matrix. Oh, sorry, adjacent vertex here. So C is removed from this list.You cannot see C and G, okay? Unvisited list. And then this is the process 7. 7, we have the sub process, right? 7.1. So you have to add H into the minimum spanning tree, right? So the result will be what? So you have to join. Join is the same as the set operation. When you want to join the element into the set, right? MST is equal to, is assigned by join MST, right? Initially, MST is empty set, if you could remember, and you have to, what? To add the edge. What is the edge of this one? U, what is U? U is G and stack peak is C, right? So, GC has been assigned into this minimum spending tree MST. Okay, this is the first step. Right, add an H into minimum spending tree set. ทันไหมคะฮัลโหล Are you still with me? Okay. I will try to explain you step by step. Okay? I will go slowly. Okay, next. So, when I add this one into the graph, if I add the edge into the graph, right? So the next thing that I would like to see is I want to see the graph, right? What's happened to the graph? So you can see that minimum spending tree has been already linked the node C and G together. So I try to write the graph right with this minimum spending tree, and then I just change the edge label to index. Edge label index. So I would like to, because for the minimum spending tree, right? If you want to assign the edge to the pair of the nodes, right, or the vertices, you have to start from 1, 2, 3, 4. That's why I use the edge label index in order to represent the order of the minimum spending tree, and I also add the edge label here, a label style to be blue and italic with the size 20. And then the coordinate still are the same. Okay, when I press. Okay, now this graph, right, it will show you only the vertices, right? And according to the vertex coordinate. And then when I add an edge here, CG, right, into the MST, right, this is the result of the minimum spending tree. So you can see that the edge now is turned on to red, and then it ticker, and then the label of the edge is 1, right? Because the edge label is indexed, and then the edge star is blue italic 20, the size is 20. Okay. So easy. And then the next step. Step 8, if there is no vertex to visit, so you have to check for to check for the length of the ADJ. ADJ is a list of adjacency vertices, right? What does it mean by length? The length is a very useful function, right, to check for the size of the array or the list. But if you want to know the number of elements in the list, you can use length, which is very easy, right? The length, if length is still greater than 0, so it means that there is still vertices to be visited. So you have to go inside this if. And then inside the if, right, pop this vertex off the stack. If the vertex is still okay, so you can use pop step. Okay, so now we can pop, after we have already visit every node below C nodes or adjacent to C node, right? So you can, okay, pop it out of the stack. And then now the current top of the stack will point to G, right? And then 8.2, right? Mark this vertex as processed. If the vertex is popped off the stack, right? It means that you have already visited this vertex, and then this vertex was processed. Okay, and then you have to the result. You have to the result of this function. The first search will be the minimum spanning tree or MST, right? So now you have to create the complete code for this, right? By combining this together. Can you? Okay, let me explain about this function. We are going to write a program in order to solve this function, to solve this function, the first search algorithm, right? The first search algorithm is a function in Mathematica, right? And there are two elements, two parameters. The first one is G, right? You can input G, which is a graph of to be processed for the first search, and then the source. Okay, and then in order to write a function, you can use colon equal signs, and then module. And module, we start with bracket and then end up with the bracket as well. So inside module, there are two parts, right? The first one is the variable variable declaration, right? And you know, this one is comments. But you can define the variables inside this list, curly bracket, and then this is a piece of code, right? So maybe we can start from the step one. So step one, what is the step one? And just simply copy. Okay, vertex. Okay, here we have to use the semicolon here. Vertex. We can define vertex unvisited, right, as a variable, right? It is a good thing for the Mathematica. You don't have to specify the type of the variable. You can just declare it. And it is a dynamic binding, right? You don't have to care about the data type. It will be changed automatically as you want. It's in the dynamic data type and stack. Okay. But you want to show the result. The result will be the MST, minimum spanning tree, MST. Sorry. Vertex with G and we should tag create. okay, this is a step one. ตามทันไหมstep 2 go for step 2 step 2 okay step 2Then push G into the stack. Okay, I will try to show the first search of G. G and node 1. Okay, MST. If I want to show the visualization, yeah, I have to use function print. Print stack visualization. Okay. Uh-huh. Okay, push G already. You go for the step 3. What is step 3? Okay, mark the vertex as. And visit it. And 4. Now while loop. Step 5. Okay, peak. Stack peak first. And then set adjacency matrix. No, adjacent vertex. Infinite loop. ไม่น่าสนเลย ยังเขียนโปรแกรมไม่เสร็จเลยเฮ้ยแมทไม่กล้าไปซะละโอ้โห have to stop the evaluation
อาจารย์ลองไปควิกเคอร์เนลดูก่อนนะครับ
เนี่ยคลิกแล้วค่ะมันออกมันไม่ได้อ่ะมันช้ามากเลยอ่ะ
วันนี้มันติดวายลูปครับมันไม่มี
มันก็หายไปอ่ะค่ะมันขึ้นแล้วมันไม่ยอมไม่เข้าไปเซตเคอร์เนลไปควิกเคอร์เนล
ตรง evaluation นะครับ
ใช่ค่ะที่ครูคลิกแล้วอ่ะมันคลิก evaluation แล้วมันไม่ขึ้นอะไรเลยอ่ะกำลังระวังแล้วนะไม่ใส่ while loopไม่รันตอน while loop ยังไม่เสร็จเนี่ยThe student you can have to break for 5 minutes and then 5 or 10 minutes and then I will come back again. Now it's 2:30. Let's just continue at 2:40. Okay, if you come back to the session, now I have already filled in the all of the whole piece of code here. and then in order to make it easier to show the graph step by step, right? Maybe you can add the create my graph here. That is the function that you can use for generate the graph neatly. Okay, and then maybe you have to use coordinate here as well. C-O-R, create my graph. Create my graph. And then the coordinate will be fixed to this one, right? Co-or here. In the create my graph, you have to use the fixed coordinate like this. Okay, maybe I will have to give you this one into like group. Okay, from this program, if you copy into the Mathematica program and then you can see the result, I will try to explain you again. Maybe this is exactly the same as Dr. Sansiri have taught to you in the morning. Okay, so this is the graph of the first search in the morning. So first of all, when you want to use the function def first search of the graph G here, starting from the source node G, right? SRC here stands for source vertex. It means a starting point or starting node. Okay, so now in this program, right? This is a program from Dr. Thuy Chai, right? He set up this one to show you the unvisited set, right? This set, and then start from G, and G will be deleted from this unvisited list. And agency list show that the node that is connected to G is R, C, and H, right? And then C push into the stack, and then connect G to C. Okay, and then now the agency list of C, right? Actually, it is D, only D, right? So D has been removed from the stack, and then push D onto the stack. D has been removed from the unvisited set, and then D push into the stack, and then C connect to D, right? That is the second label, second edge. And then from D goes to H and I, right? H and I, and we select H first, and then we push H onto the stack. So now D and H has been connected. And then now the agency list for H is not connected to any node, right? Except the D, right? But D has been already visited. So pop H off the stack. H has been popped off the stack. And then now the current position is D, right? The top of stack is D. So we have to connect, right? Before that, you can see that the node that connected to D, R, H, and I. H has already been visited. Now, only I left. Right. And then, I has been pushed onto the stack. And then, connect the edge. And so on, right? From I, right? I has many connected vertices, right? E, J, L, and M. We have to start from E. E has been pushed to the stack and then connect to E, right? E connect to A, right? Then A. And then A connect to nothing, right? So then we come back to E. And E starting from A, so we'll go to B, right? E has B and F, B, right? If you want to try to understand about the differences step by step, this program is very good for you to try to understand step by step, okay? And in B, B connect to nothing else, then come back to E. When you pop up, pop B out of the stack, right? And then go to E, right? But E has B and F, right? So we go to F, that is the edge, the eight. And then F pop, F connect to J, F connect to J, so the 9 H will connect to J. And then F, pop F, adjacency list of J is nothing, it's empty list. So pop, for F, pop, right? Nothing, E, nothing, pop. Come back to I. I is L and M. Then press push L. Right, and then connect I and L. And then the last M, right? L connected to M. And then M connect to nothing, right? And then pop M, pop L, pop I, pop D, pop C, and pop G, right? There is no vertices connected to K, and K will be the isolated node. Okay, and that's all. So the result from this, the differences will be the minimum spanning tree of this graph. Okay. Okay, now you may have to try to understand about the program, the mathematical program of this